the child was only about 15 weeks. We knew that child was not going to live, but the child had a heartbeat. The child took gasps and tried to leave. And we would give that baby to the mother, wrap it in a nice cloth and warm cloth, and hand that to the mother. The child usually didn't live like an hour or so. The same thing happens today. I actually took the liberty of calling the chairman of obstetrics at my university today, speaking with him and asking him a few questions, because as I said, I'm not a liberated in the United States quite a while. In the state of North Carolina today, if a baby is born through miscarriage, through a spontaneous miscarriage, that has a heartbeat, regardless of its age, be it 16 weeks, 18 weeks, 22 weeks, 26 weeks, that child is given a birth certificate. And at 15 weeks, 18 weeks, 20 weeks, that child probably will not survive without being resuscitated, without taking the thank you, death of the 21 weeks or so. So the child is given a birth certificate, and then if the child lives now, because their lungs are just not developed, the child is then given a death certificate. So tell me now, in the state of North Carolina, where now there is no age limit, there is no term to when an abortion can be done, what is the difference between a child who comes out of the womb at 26 weeks before they should, and one that is aborted at 26 weeks because someone wanted them to? They both have a heartbeat. They are both breathing. One will have a birth certificate, and the other one, for some reason, because of the intention of its delivery, will not. So again, I plead with you, this is not about the discussion of a woman's right to abortion. This is merely the discussion of when a child is born alive, with a heartbeat, attempting to breathe, that would get a birth certificate. Why would it not render the appropriate aid? The appropriate aid at 15 weeks, 16 weeks, we know, is wrapping that child in a warm cloth and handing it to its mother. Because we know the lungs are not going to be viable to allow that child to live. Yet at 20 weeks, things get a little bit more blurred. 22 weeks, we get a little bit more blurred. We look at APGAR scores for viability. Why? And I ask you to see this with your heart. Why would you vote against when a child is born with a heartbeat, even though the intention was for that child not to be there? Why would you vote against my colleagues rendering the force to render aid to that child, even if it's just alienation? I mean, please don't make this the issue that is not. It is not about abortion rights. It's about right for existence. I plead with your hearts. Please don't throw the politics over our subsidies out the window. Please remember we're all part of humankind. We're called to be kind and loving. That is all we're asking. That is literally all we are asking. So please, throw the political persuasions, throw the political arguments away. We talk about doing this for the children. And we talk about doing this for our infants and for life. So please ask that you override this veto.